dysfunction of the Digital Sports Management System, or DSMS, often pronounced DISMOS. We'll conduct this lesson right here on the ramp, so I'm going to run the batteries and bring up some systems. DSMS is primary information of the pilot of the system. In the ATC weapon profile, not merely selecting the weapon per se, but selecting the profile of the weapon design. For example, break multiple profiles for a particular weapon compared to various tactical scenarios. DSMS allows you to create a sub-model of 20 profiles at each stage of the unique manual. Profiles can be cycled by DSMS controls of the UFC, the select blocker of the UFC, or hook test controls of another source. Selected profile is called an anchor profile, and it's displayed on the bottom left corner of the HUD. DSMS includes the following pages: status page, inventory select page, selected medicine page, and missile control page. Some of these have additional subpages. The DTS upload page is now up. Press OSD 18 on the left MSC to upload the DSMS data. Okay, now let's select the DSMS page with OSD 14. We are now looking at the status page, which is the primary display of the DSMS. This page allows you to quickly view the following information: weapon inventory and status for particular level stations, release settings for the active profile, gun status and ammunition information, field power timer to get an average action. At the top of the display, OSD 1, 4, and 5 allow you to access the applications of the display. Without pressing any buttons, take a moment to become familiar with the display. Press the space bar and you are ready to proceed. Let's set the master arm to training mode. Left click once to set the switch to train. The blue indication on the DSMS denotes training mode. White indicates master arm safe, green indicates master arm on. As you can see, stations 1 through 11 are displayed sequentially clockwise, starting from the bottom left corner. Each station box indicates the profile name, which usually corresponds to the designation of the weapon and the quantity remaining. Depending on the weapon, additional information may be contained inside the box, such as loss configuration or weapon sensor status. In the bottom center of the display, the cannon data block indicates the ammunition type and amount remaining. The center of the display indicates the current HUD mode and additional details of an active profile when one is selected. Press the space bar to proceed. Starting with Station 1 on the left side of the aircraft, we are carrying an ALQ-131 CM pod, an LAU-68 2.75-inch rocket pod with 7 training rounds loaded, an APN-65 BRU-22 rack with 3 training bombs, and a GB-38. Continuing to the right side, we have another GB-38, another BRU-22 rack, APN-65K, AN-882-28 lightning pod, and the LAU-105 launcher loaded with 3M9M. We are also carrying 1,150 target practice rounds for the demo. Let's first cycle through the default profile loaded from the DTS. To do this, we need to take the HUD out of guns mode and into either CCIP or CCRP mode. Press the Hold Test Master Mode button for the M key on the keyboard once. We can now cycle the profiles into the select rock DLC. Alternatively, because the HUD is currently stored, you can press the Home tab CMS left or right command, or delete the page down on the keyboard. To see a list of all loaded profiles, let's enter the profile main page by pressing OSP1. Profile main page presents a list of all loaded profiles. Press OSP19 to designate the WPG Rocket profile with a pointing arrow. You can now move this profile up and down the list using OSP 6 and 7. Disable the profile with OSP 9 and activate the profile with OSP 17. However, let's instead press OSP 3 to enter the profile control page with the settings for this profile. The profile control page displays the weapon settings you set in the current profile. You can alter the settings along the left and right sides of the display. The settings in the profile table in the center of the display can also be changed left from other pages. OSP 19 and 20 will cycle through the profile without making them active. Let's try changing some of these settings within profile. Looking at the right side of the display, you can see the current release quantity is set to single. This means that for each press of the weapon release button, only a single rocket will be fired. Let's change this to ripple single by pressing OSP 6 twice. Press the space bar key to receive one set. Now set the ripple quantity to determine how many rockets will be fired while the weapon release button is held down. For example, to set the quantity to 3, press button 3 on the UFC, and then OSP 8 to enter the dive into the profile. Press the spacebar key to proceed to the set. Additional options on this page include OSP 10 to set the default HUD mode, and OSP 18 to paste current profile settings into a new profile. Press OSP 16 to enter the profile settings subpage to access additional settings underlined in the data table of the display. You can now see additional profile settings. On the left side of the display, these include the escape maneuver, desired time of flight, and minimum altitude. On the right side of the display, you can set the horizontal offset, vertical offset, weapon eject velocity, and bomb activate. Press OSP 3 to save the changes to this profile. We are now back on the profile main page. Just as we did with the WTU profile, you can select and edit any of the other profiles. Press OSP 1 to return to the PSMS status page. Profiles can also be accessed in manual mode by selecting station field OSPs directly on the status page. Multiple stations can be selected if they are loaded with identical weapons, launchers, and profile settings. Press OSP 7 and 19 to select stations 4 and 8 loaded with DRU routers. Note the additional profile information in the center of the display. The profile name now begins with an import slash to indicate manual mode. Profile operations in manual mode are identical to default profiles, but the profile is standalone and cannot be cycled to unless it is saved into the DSMS. Pressing the profile or C1 while in manual mode will open the profile control page directly. Let's take a look at the profile settings available for BOM Rooms. BOM profile includes the additional option of the view settings for OSP 7. This can be cycled between node for node keeping, tail for tail keeping, and NT for node and tail keeping. Press OSP 6 twice to change the release setting to triple sync OSP accelerator for rocket. Press the spacebar key to proceed from set. With BOM release set to a ripple setting, you can also adjust the ripple quantity and impact separation in feet. Let's change the impact separation to 150 feet. Type in 150 into the HUD scratch pad into the UFC, and then press OSP 9 to enter the value into the PSMS. Press the spacebar key to proceed from set. Now save the changes with OSP 3. Press OSP 1 to return to the PSMS status page. Next, let's take a look at the missile control page accessed by pressing OSP 2 from the status page. The missile control page is used to configure the AGM TGM-65 and A9 missiles. We'll discuss the Maverick missiles first. OSP 4 enables and disables power to the Maverick seeker head. Whenever the seeker head is activated, it will need 3 minutes to unlock, so this should be done prior to entering the target area. Once activated, a field timer is displayed in the bottom right corner of the display. You can try pressing the button now, but note that in training mode, the DSMS will not actually power up the seeker. OSP 5 selects between manual, location, and time mode of applying real power. In manual mode, the seeker head is only powered by the pilot pressing the fuel power OSP. In location mode, the seeker head is powered at a set range and varying from a specified waypoint. In time mode, the seeker head is powered at a specific clock time. Press OSP 5 to set the location automatic power function. Press the spacebar key to proceed when set. Configuring the location automatic power on function requires a few steps. First, select the waypoint rotary by pressing OSP 9. You should see the up-down rotary arrow on the OSP become highlighted. Press the function button on the UFC, indicated by the F adjacent to the UFC scratch pad on the HUD, and press the select rocker up to cycle to the next waypoint. You will see the waypoint number change on the missile control page. Press the spacebar key to proceed with the set. Now, to enter bearing and range, type in a bearing value in the UFC, for example, 065, and press OSP 7. Then, type in a range value, for example, 20, followed by OSP 8. Press the spacebar key to proceed when set. power will now be applied to the Maverick automatically as you approach 20 nautical miles at 0.65 from the designated waypoint. The diameter of the activation point is 10 nautical miles or 25% of the set range for the waypoint, whichever is greater. When set to time mode, the time eel power function on 4SB10 is used to enter a clock time diagram in a similar fashion as you can prepare the range information for location mode. The Maverick foresight adjust function on 4SB6 is used to set the foresight to the information speed. On the left side of the display, 4SB19 is the rotary function to set the A9 missiles to off, cool, and select mode. When set to select, the HUD mode changes to air. Press OSB1 again to return to the GSMS status page. Next, we'll take a look at the Jetson select page. Press OSB4. The Jetson select page is similar to the status page, except you are now selecting the source Jetson. OSB4 is a rotary function to select between these options. OSB5 is a rotary to select between the following jettison modes. STR, store. When in STR mode, the user can jettison stores from one or more selected stations. Stores are released from the air mode. Rack, station rack. When in rack mode, the user can select one or multiple stations that have racks assigned to them and jettison them along with any stores attached to them. If more than one station is selected that is assigned a rack, then they are released in a paired mode. A rack or a pair of racks is jettisoned when you press a weapon release button. MSL, missile. In this mode, any Maverick assigned to an LAV-88 tier will be launched in an unguided, unarmed mode with the pressing of the weapon release button. If both tiers are selected, Mavericks will be launched in pairs. MSL jettison is not available for the LAV-117. If a station is selected that is not loaded for the LAV-88 and Maverick, only the station number will be displayed in the first video. When you are ready, press OSB-1 to return to the status page. For our last topic of the lesson, let's enter the inventory select page, OSB-5. The primary function of the inventory page is to allow you to assign a weapon to a specified weapon station. This allows you to correct an error when the weapon type does not match the one specified in the profile, and it allows you to set the weapon setting not available in the profile for this page. It also allows you to create your container for your training. Outside of a malfunction that produces an error, you should not have a need to access this page in normal operation. All the default profiles for the weapon loaded on the jet. However, we'll try setting up one station as an example. Press the spacebar to proceed from ready. We'll reset the Maverick on station 3. First, press OSB-18 to select the station. Now press OSB-18 again to select missile as a weapon class. And now you can select the specific missile model loaded. Notice also you can select between missile types with OSB-4, missile quantity with OSB-5, and launcher configuration with OSB-8. Press OSB-18 once more to select UCM-65. Let's return to the status page with OSB-1. This concludes the training lesson on the